Aha. There's a crate up here. Am I right on top of me? This close. I think I'm getting there. Can't let the cold distract me. Made it. Another relic. According to this data, this thing might have had something to do with Las Vegas. Maybe I should head back there.
Get my tools ready. We're making some armor.
The locator shows there's another recording in there. Must be stuck. Signal's coming from beneath these boxes at the back of the plane. A little more intact than some of the others out here. I wonder if I can find anything interesting inside.
Aloy! Oh, your timing couldn't be better. Over here! Aloy! Oh, this is a grand day. Greatness is in the air. Or, will be soon.
Greatness, huh?
Behold, I call it Morlin's Amazing Elevating Orb, inspired by the floating spheres the Banuk use for their clan contests. When aloft, this grand construction will be a spectacle henceforth unseen by the eyes of the living. Unburdened by gravity, it'll be a floating beacon, drawing people from great distances to our destination of wonders and amusement.
Except...
we're missing one key piece. A mechanical burner. Small, magnificent design. Old world ingenuity at its peak. We found it when we opened up more of the ruins below and discovered numerous statues of strange winged serpents. One such statue had the burner in its mouth. Oh, no doubt part of some ancient fire-filled spectacle. Oh, Aloy, it's perfect for the orb. But a swarm of burrowers chased us out before I could grab it. Could you get it? Please?
Okay, Morland, you got me. I'm curious. I'll get it for you.
I knew I could count on you! Okay, okay. Head down to where we fought that Tide Ripper after you drained all the water. When you get down there, head right and look for a room to the side. The statue you want is up high, looming like a nightmare. Oh, and if you'd like a smoother descent into the ruins, use the elevator. Just head back into the building and go upstairs.
Got it. I'll see what I can do.
Stupendous. Thank you. I await your return.
I keep hearing about people riding machines around here. Not sure what they want or where they came
from. Be welcome, Outlander.
Ah, Red! Just who I need.
You know her? Great! Then tell her that going out there is a bad bet.
Well, you tell him he better crank out what he knows before I pummel him in.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow down, Della. What's going on?
It's my sister, Boomer. She ran off into the desert. We had a fight. I told her we'd discuss it in the morning after we both had time to cool off. But when I woke up, she was gone. And Spectacles over here was the only one to see her leave. But he refuses to tell me which way she went.
You can't go striking off into the desert. You'll get lost. And if thirst doesn't kill you, the Vanishing Dread will. You know what happened to the Delvers who went out there last? No, you don't. No one does, because they didn't come back.
Well, what about my sister? She's out there all alone.
Maybe she's a sunk cost.
I'm asking you, Red. Help me find her.
What's the Vanishing Dread?
That's what Stemmer calls the machine that stalks the sands out there. Sometimes you'll see it in the distance. A stationary blur of metal. It'll stay like that for hours. And then the next time you look, gone. Like it was never there.
But what kind of machine is it?
Don't know. No one's ever gotten close enough to find out. A few of those Delvers went out there once, but all they found was a bunch of sand dunes. But I don't care what it is. It's not gonna stop me from finding my sister.
What brought you and Boomer out west?
That. There was an accident in Chainscrape.
An explosive accident?
Well, you know how Boomer is. So we grabbed our tools and skipped town. Heard about a caravan striking out west after some passage got reopened. Decided to join up.
But why come out here? You could have gone anywhere.
Can't really go back to the claim, and anywhere else is a little too inhabited. At least out here, there's less chance of collateral damage. Besides, this place is gonna be a destination one day, right? Dad always said, get in early.
If you think I can be bribed, know that I only take shards up front. No credit.
Maybe we got in too early.
The argument you had with Boomer? What was it about?
Well, it started out as the same old spark and boom. I found her tinkering with one of my prototypes, trying to add explosives, as usual. And when I reminded her that the last time she did that, she nearly burned the whole place down, she just looked at me and shrugged. Then we got into this whole scorched out mess about why we had to leave Chainscrape and come out here. Why, for the love of the Forge, she has to blow everything up.
And what did Boomer say?
Well, that's the thing. She didn't say anything. She just sat there, ignoring me. Even when I went to bed, not a word. And then, when I woke up in the morning, she was gone. She's never done that before. But knowing her, she's gonna get into some kind of trouble out there. And that's why I need to find her.
If Boomer's lost in the desert, I might be able to find her.
I'm coming with you. All this is my fault anyway.
But you'll die.
Where did you last see her?
I suppose if you're with her, the odds of survival do go up. I thought I saw her heading towards the metal arches east of here.
Then that's where we'll start. I'll meet you at the arches.
Okay. Join me there as soon as you can.
Fair enough. But next time, try my brews.
Tanakh rebels holed up in an outpost nearby need a beating, Huntress.
Victor! Over here! finally.
Tanakh rebels holed up in an outpost nearby need a beating, Huntress.
Promise of another adventure.
Stemmer, did you need something?
As a new dream dawned for the adventuring trio, they returned to the depths of the formerly sunken city, where fortune was found behind every crumbling wall as a bulging keg bursts with free-flowing ale. That is, we broke our way into more of the ruins below, and in one of them, the wordsmith beheld a glimmering gizmo, a wonder among a sea of wonders. Alas, the gizmo lay beyond his grasp.
You saw some kind of gizmo but couldn't get it?
A door bars the way, locked by some confounded means. Moreland contemplated explosives, but Abaddon thought the odds of crushing the gizmo under rubble were too high. For once, the Shard Counter's skepticism might be warranted. The old wordsmith's hopes were dashed, until a friend with a knack for performing the impossible returned from beyond the sands. Might I persuade you to venture beneath the desert once more?
I'll see what I can do. Where is this place?
Once you're down there, take a right at the statue of the giant man. The ruin rests beside a metal tower. And so our heroine went forth, and the wordsmith's hopes went with her.
Good use of this.
Nothing like taking...
I don't have to swim down anymore. Okay, there's the giant statue that Stemmer mentioned. The ruin should be nearby.
fight.
I think I'm out of range of the vista point. I gotta try again. An image from the old vault. Looks like part of the city inside the dome. I think the image was taken from somewhere above ground level. There used to be a bridge around here. The image was taken from somewhere above ground level. Maybe there used to be a bridge around here? I can get a good view of the city from
there. It is!
I think I'm in the right place. Now, where's that gizmo? There. That must be the gizmo. Looks like this door needs a code to open. I should check around the room, see if I can find anything that might help. What's in here? So the gizmo is actually called an ornament. I found one of these in another ruin. It sounds like there are more out there. And it looks like there's part of a code. Might be for the door. I better keep looking around. Maybe I can find the rest of it. Pull this out. Looks like the crate on top's blocked. There we go. Put it back up. Try again. Might lead to another part of the ruin. But how to get to it? There's an opening at the top of the fence. Could be a way in, if I can find a way to get up there. Should be able to reach the opening now. Made it. I won't budge from this side. Try further back. Let's see where this leads. And back outside. What else is up here? It's no good. There's the pole caster on that. More of a ruin in there. Looks like... The ornaments were part of something called the Knights of Lights holiday promotion? A way to celebrate old world holidays by changing the holograms above ground? But how? Part of the cards here too. I should have what I need to open the door. Nope, that's not it. What is it? I don't think that's the code. Got it. I'll head back up to Stemmer. Maybe we can figure out how to make this thing work. stash this away for later. This looks like the place. No burrowers, though. And that must be the statue. Okay, gotta find a way up there. This could be useful. To reach the statue. Now to get the burner.
Made it.
Whoa!
Well, I got the burner. Better take it back to Moreland.
Burrowers. Might have been the ones that attacked Moreland.
delve into the deep.
Seemed like they were racing or something. Back.
The Nora returned, but did she bring tidings of triumph or misfortune?
I got the gizmo, and it's not the only one I found. Here.
The old wordsmith, a keen spark in his eye and gratitude in his heart, held aloft the gizmo that had eluded him.
It's called an ornament, actually. Part of a set.
Huh. You know, some delvers tapped a ruin north of here recently and said they saw a trinket like this one, beyond their reach. Might have been another one of these ornaments.
That's worth looking into.
And so the mystery of the ornament deepened. For what purpose were these trinkets designed?
Something called the Knights of Light's holiday promotion. It's a way the old ones celebrated special occasions, I think.
Like feasts?
Kind of. I think a holiday marked a seasonal event.
And so does every feast in the claim. There's the Feast of the First Keg, the Feast of Fermentation, the All Hops Feast.
All about ale, huh? I guess I shouldn't be surprised. Anyway, these ornaments could supposedly change the lights above ground, but I'm not sure how.
I recognize this marking. Saw the same on a little device we unearthed. Here.
It might be able to turn on the lights.
Time to find out. Which one should I try first?
Let's go with this one.
I'll get right to it. As sure as sparks kindle flame, this must have been some kind of winter festival. But what kind of beast is that? Almost looks like a fanghorn. Let me know if you find any more of those ornaments. Wonder what other holidays the old ones celebrate. So she entered once more, our heroine, whom all adore. So, did you want to make some changes around here?
This one seems good.
I hope Abaddon is ready for this. Beneath the cascade of golden leaves, the old wordsmith found himself reflecting inwards. Meditation of the mind, and a calming of the spirit. Aloy, this old wordsmith is always happy to see you. So, did you want to change the lights?
I want to see this one.
And so the wordsmith set out to bring new light to the ruins above. A lot of hearts flying around. I'd bet shards this one's dedicated to the romantic arts. Good. So,
let's see this one.
You got it. Why, by the forge, would the old ones celebrate some kind of green leaf?
It's for luck, I think.
Traveling at night, huh? Well, if you need to find your way back here, just follow the lights.
You're back! Did you get it? Do you have the device? Oh, please say you do. Oh, we're so close to something truly majestic.
Here you go, Moreland.
Yes! Yes! Thank you. I hope getting it wasn't too much trouble. Oh, this design, it's so compact. Oh, the ancients knew how to make them. It should fit the housing like a dream. Just need to cinch up the blaze leads and away we go.
We?
Make the maiden flight without the maiden who played such a vital part? My mother raised me better than that.
You should have the honor of seeing the world in a way that no one alive has ever seen it. How about it?
How can I say no to that?
Nothing to worry about. We have a sturdy tether connecting us to the ground. Pure Oseram craftsmanship. Well, time to give it a little flame. Aha! We ascend! Behold, the world beneath our feet. Ah, the sky at our fingertips.
The burner heats the air inside, which gets lighter than what surrounds it. So we rise.
Indeed. We're powered by hot air.
Just like Stemmer.
But don't tell him I said that. We are on the cusp of history. The first successful Oseram flight.
There have been other attempts?
Oh, yeah! The history of Oseram flights is fascinating. And, you know, violent and frequently incendiary.
I feel like you should have mentioned this before.
Ah, the others failed because their machines were too heavy and complex. They were begging to crash. Not here. Just a pilot compartment, blaze, a burner, the orb, and a tether. Within simplicity, there is perfection. Well, at least, you know, less chance of exploding. You know, if Abaddon were here, he'd be drunk like a wastrel. Crippling fear of heights. That said, he gets poetic when drunk. He has evocative rhymes about all his various ledgers. A little known fact, Oseram poetry started as work songs and forges around the claim.